Hello and greetings from Iceland. This update will be short actually, since I just returned today from a 7-day tour with lots of footage that needs color grading, sorting and such before I start editing. And before that, I wanted to mention the most recent news from the Reykjanes Peninsula, because it will likely be tomorrow, Saturday, that the magma chamber reaches its lower threshold, so the volcano alert has been elevated, and I have actually been around there for a few days now, after my tour over the highlands, and I did not see a reason to be waiting for this eruption that could even start tomorrow, because I have the feeling that we will have to wait for a bit longer. And that feeling was actually so strong that I left my drone flagship at the DJI dealership to be shipped abroad for service. And I would never have left it there if I would expect a volcanic eruption to start soon. I noticed that we would have several bad days as for weather, where drone flying would be impossible or excellent timing to get the drone serviced. And I do actually have a backup drone if things would heat up. But when? That is the big question. It looks to me as the Met Office is expecting this sooner than later. And a frequently named professor here on the channel made a remark in the news shortly after the announcement from the Met Office. And that was Professor Þorvaldur Þórðarson, and he is, as usual, not on the same page as them. So he's talking about late November or even December, but it remains unclear why he is saying so. The upper bound is 23 million cubic meters, and it will be reached on December 18th, provided that the inflow continues at the same rate. But experience shows that the threshold for an event to begin varies a whole lot between eruptions. So yet again, I'm using this word uncertainty, and experience shows that the sooner this starts, the better outcome we will get. So we want this to start sooner than later, of course. And the last eruptions, they have actually been fairly easy to handle. And my wild guess this time is October 15th, and I think it's likely that we will see a similar event as last time, since the magma has obviously found a good path that it has been reusing quite often, and I don't see anything indicating that the next event will be in some way different, although it would be no surprise if the next eruption would take place further northeast than last time, even further than ever before, since that has been the development. And not even Professor Þorvaldur is saying anything about the future now. When will this come to an end, this chapter? And when Þorvaldur is silent, you can just imagine what the others say. And that is no surprise. Every time we see some kind of pattern emerge, it turns out to be a teaser. And all we get is a surprise. I am, however, saying again what I've said before. I think the worst is over at this location by Grindavík. So I've been focusing more and more at other locations, like Lake Klevarvatn. And I'm not going to spend more time wondering about the next eruption now. We don't even see any earthquakes there to work with. And as for my filming recently, it has been going well. So I have never before had so much footage to work with. And since I'm back in the north, now is the time to sit down and do some color grading. But I'm also working on the travel story I mentioned in a recent update. That story just got a bit longer, and it's a good way to show you all sorts of footage. And although the summer is over, the autumn has been extremely mild, and this time of year can be extremely photogenic. Not just the colors, it's the other elements as well that tend to put on a show. So when I'm further into color grading, I will have a good autumn show for you. So this quick update was just to show you where I am in this process, or back in the north, and I hope you enjoyed the samples that I've been showing you, or those little teasers from projects that will be online soon. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.